Good afternoon, students. Today we will be seeing about tuberculosis. This is another disease in infectious diseases. Tuberculosis is known to cause by a mycobacterium, and that is called as Mycobacterium tuberculosis. It is attacking the respiratory tract, that means mostly the lungs, and it is a droplet infection. What is the meaning of droplet? That means it can be spread through the moisture or through the sputum, infected sputum, which is expelled out from a person. And suppose if that moisture, infected moisture or sputum, if a healthy person comes in contact, in that way it can spread from a from a infected person to a healthy. Droplet means a small part of a liquid, and this spreads through coughing or sneezing from an infected person to a healthy person. Mycobacterium tuberculosis is the important bacteria which is known to cause TB. That is a short form, also called as tuberculosis. Apart from that, there is Mycobacterium tubercle complex. That means what? There are other four bacteria also which may cause tuberculosis. They are Mycobacterium bovis, Mycobacterium africanum, Mycobacterium microti, and Mycobacterium canetti. Apart from this, Mycobacterium leprae is also known to cause tuberculosis. Then, risk factor or causes, if we see, causes already we have seen, it is a droplet type of infection. So, the main spread of this disease is when a healthy person coughs, when he coughs or sneezes, the moisture or whatever the drops of the liquid which is coming from his respiratory tract, that is the way of transmission. Risk factor means what? In the presence of certain conditions, the person may get affected with tuberculosis. So the people with HIV infection or the people with respiratory tract infection, for example pneumonia, or the person having lymphoma, or the person has undergone any surgery, and there are the chances of infection, or even diabetes, those person who are having diabetes. So these people are at risk to cause tuberculosis. Next important in that is pathogenesis. Pathogenesis, if you see, it's very simple to understand. It is similar to that of your typhoid fever. If you remember, we have earlier seen typhoid fever, also called as enteric fever. Similar to that, the pathogenesis of tuberculosis is based. Now here what happens, Mycobacterium tuberculosis, when it gains entry inside the respiratory tract, it directly attacks the alveoli. When it attacks the alveoli, whatever the macrophages which are present in the alveoli, that will try to fight against this. They will take up this bacteria and they will fight against this bacteria. How they will fight? They will try to build a vesicle like structure which is called as phagosome. This phagosome, it combines with lysosome, and the enzymes or the toxic substances of lysosome will try to destroy this phagosome containing bacteria. That is what is the normal activity. But here what happens, this Mycobacterium tubercle is very strong. Suppose if the immune system is not able to destroy this, Mycobacterium tubercle wall is very thick, made up of mycolic waxy material, and this waxy material is not getting destroyed, and the bacteria within the macrophage itself is growing and replicating and destroying our immune cells. So here the cells are incapable of destroying this bacteria, and that is how it grows. So it may form a foci. Foci means what? It will select one particular target area, there it will grow, and it will form a white color patch. It is seen when radiography or when special type of scanning, CT scan, or X-ray is done. So that is how it targets the part of the lungs. It may affect the upper part of the lower lobes or the lower part of the upper lobes of the lungs. So that type of spread is done by this Mycobacterium tuberculosis. What it forms? It forms a foci. Foci means it forms or it targets a particular area, then it grows, replicates and forms a white color patch, which is called as a tubercle. Now, this microorganism, if it is not stopped, it may spread from lungs to the other tissues. For example, lymph nodes, it may affect kidneys, it may affect brain also. But rarely it is affecting heart or you can say skeletal muscles. Then, now suppose if this tubercle in this or tuberculosis in this way, if it is attacking or damaging the different parts of the organs, such forming tubercle, such type of tuberculosis is called as miliary tuberculosis. And this is generally spread through blood. That means this microorganism, it will come from that lung and it will grow in the blood. And from the blood, it will migrate to the different organs and affect or damage that different organs. Such type of a serious destruction of the lung tissue is called as miliary tuberculosis. That is how it spreads and it grows within the body. Okay, I hope you have understood pathogenesis. It's very easy to understand, similar to that of your typhoid fever. Then if you see the symptoms, now as we have seen how it spreads, coughing and sneezing. So the most common symptoms is there is continuous coughing which lasts for about 3 weeks, and if the disease is spread at a very larger space or area within the respiratory system, this cough is accompanied with blood and mucus. That means the mucus with blood. Apart from that, the person may not be able to eat properly. So there is loss of appetite. Due to loss of appetite, the person may suffer from weight loss. Along with that, fever, which is also seen to accompanied with chills, shivering. That is also one of the common symptoms. Then during coughing, chest pain can be experienced by some of the patient because that cough is continuous. Okay. Apart from that, sweating at night time. So these are some of the common symptoms which are seen during the tuberculosis disease. Next, if we see diagnosis, for diagnosis, physical examination, that is medical history, can be taken down. Then blood test can be done. As we have seen, there are chances the tuberculosis may have spread from lungs to blood. So Mycobacterium can be detected in blood. Third test, we can go for scanning, that is special type of X-ray can be taken, or a CT scan or radiography can be done. So that is also a clear picture we will get where exactly the tubercle, that is the white color patches, formed. Then a sputum test, that is also a very best test, because here we have seen in symptoms that sputum is expelled out, which may have, which is having this Mycobacterium tuberculosis. So sputum analysis can be done. One more important test is Montaux test. Montaux, or it is also called as positive pulmonary disease test. Okay. Now what is this Montaux test? That means here a intradermal injection of a bacterial protein, that is the tuberculosis protein, is given to that particular patient, and it may produce red color, you can say bumps, if the person is positive to the Mycobacterium. So that can be done. That is one of the important tuberculin test, also called as Montaux test. So diagnosis is very easy by sputum, by scanning, or even Montaux test. That are some of the major diagnostic tests. And if we see the treatment, now as it is an infection, so mainly here antibiotics can be prescribed. Now antibiotics, the most potent antibiotics which are active against tuberculosis is isoniazid. You might have heard this word many times in other diseases also, rimfampin, ethambutol, pyrizinamide, all these are the antibiotics which can be given to decrease the spread of the tuberculosis. Then what are the prevention, how we can prevent? Now as we have seen, it is a droplet type of infection, so we can look after the personal hygiene, or we can wear a mask whenever we are not well or whenever we are going out. In that way we can prevent, or we can be at a safe distance so that we don't come in contact with the infected person. In that way we can try to prevent this mycobacterium tuberculosis. Then complications, if you see, the person may suffer from joint pain, or the person may also suffer from skeletal muscles. They may become weak. Weight loss is one of the also complication. Then sometimes the person may suffer from heart disorders and swelling, that is the inflammation of brain is also sometimes seen. If you remember, in meningitis we have seen one of the reason infection, that is the bacteria. So if this tuberculosis spreads to the brain, there are the chances it may cause inflammation to the protective cover of the brain and spinal cord. Okay, so that is all for tuberculosis. Thank you.